Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to talk about a tool that lets you create graphics design in a consistent way. In this one, the problem with Photoshop is that it requires a lot of expertise to handle, and another one, Canva, generally you have to rely on templates, and even if you want something custom from Canva, you have to make sure that it's consistent in terms of style. But at the end of the day, it doesn't create a really coherent image. And other text generation tools like DALL-E and Midjourney, you have to really be great at prompting, and sometimes they don't nail that composition really good. So for example, something like a thumbnail, this tool would be really good. You want to create a poster which is a beach party poster. So I have found one background which is similar to a beach. Imported another poster of a beach party. I'll zoom it in. They have an option to remove background, so you can click on this and it would remove the background. So essentially you have to create a collage of the final image that you want and then use their inbuilt styles to create like a really consistent one. Now that I have a DJ here, I can insert one object. I have to paint on the area where I need the object. Now that I have selected the area, I can put the object that I want to add here. So let's click on generate, and it would give me four options. This is similar to Photoshop and you can use this for free. See, as you can see, the first one is really consistent with the background and last one is slightly mismatching. This one is really hit it out of the park, so I'll click on this one. If I'm not happy, I can just click regenerate, and now I have the original one here and the generated one here. So I'll delete the previous one. Now that I have a collage of a DJ partying on a beach, now I have to go to image to image. Now I have a bunch of styles that I can select. In this one also, I can get tags that would help me to understand what type of style is this. Maybe you want like a little boy playing the DJ, you can put a prompt here. You can also click on this button, which would analyze the image and generate a prompt for you. You can just customize it. So that would be better option in my opinion, because you don't have to structure the prompt. It's basically analyzing the image and creating it for us. So like this, a woman wearing purple t-shirt and sitting behind two DJ turntables. Now if you want like a child here to play the DJ, something like that, you can make it. And then now structure match is something that how close you want your final image to match this structure. So I would click on one. So it's generating four options for me, and from that I have to select one to replace it on the canvas. I think the first one is really good. I can click on this and place on canvas. Now as you can see, it has placed that thing on canvas, and I can remove the original images that I have prepared to create this image. Another use case of this tool is to transfer the style of your photo into something else. For example, you can make it into an anime or a 3D model of your photos. This is me standing outdoors, and I can click on image to image and select something else. Now after I have selected the style and I haven't given any prompt, you can even give prompts if you want something else. Based on that, it has given me four options. First one is slightly 3D-ish, and I really like this one because it matches with my photograph really closely. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one, where we'll talk about more fun AI stuff.